Hello students, I Pushpinder Kaur welcome you in the another video lecture based on the solubility of liquid in liquid. Today we will discuss very important topic, Rawls law. From this topic both the theory as well as the numerical portion is important, so we will concentrate on both numerical part and the theory part. As we already learned what is a vapor pressure of the pure liquid. Firstly, we will discuss the Rawls law for the volatile liquids. Volatile liquids means which boils at the lower temperature. For this, we have to take a liquid-liquid solution in a closed container. Suppose this is a closed container filled with the solution of liquid 1 and the liquid 2. The black one is a liquid 1 and the red one is a liquid 2. Suppose both the liquids exerted the pressure of P1 and P2 on the surface of the liquid. Here P1 and P2 are the partial vapor pressure of liquid 1 and the liquid 2 respectively. Here the partial pressure means the pressure exerted by the liquid 1 and liquid 2 individually on the surface of the liquid. And X1 and X2 are the mole fractions of liquid 1 and the liquid 2 in the solution. Remember, these are the mole fractions of liquid 1 and liquid 2 in the solution. In the vapor phase, we are taking the mole fraction of liquid 1 and liquid 2 is Y1 and Y2. Y1 is a mole fraction of liquid 1 in vapor phase. And Y2 is a mole fraction of liquid 2 in the vapor phase. Now we know that the total pressure exerted by this solution in this closed container is sum of the partial pressure of P1 and P2. This is according to the Dalton's law. According to the Dalton's law, P total is equal to the partial pressure of liquid 1 and the partial pressure of the liquid 2. Now, according to the Rawls law, the partial vapor pressure of volatile component above its ideal solution is directly proportional to its mole fraction in solution at given temperature. Here, solution means we are taking only X1 and X2 as the mole fraction. According to the definition, the mathematical portion is like this. The partial pressure is directly proportional to the mole fraction. Now, this solution having the two components, component 1 and the component 2. According to the Rawls law, the partial pressure of liquid 1 is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the liquid 1. And for the component 2, partial pressure is directly proportional to the mole fraction of liquid 2. Now, P1 is equal to P1 nod X1. Instead of the proportionality sign, we apply equal to the sign and introducing a new constant term P1 nod. And P2 is equal to P2 nod X2. Here P1 nod and P2 nod are the vapor pressure of the pure liquid. Now, according to the Dalton's law, P total is equal to the P1 plus P2. Now, we have the values of P1 and P2. Put the value of P1 and P2 in this equation. P1 is equal to the P nod X1 and P2 is equal to the P nod 2 X2. Now, we know that X1 plus X2 is equal to 1, minus X2, or the value of X2 is 1 minus X1. Firstly, we will put the value of X1 in equation 1. P total, that is equal to P1 nod. Instead of the X1, we can write 1 minus X2 plus P2 nod X2. multiply the P1 naught on rearranging, we can write this equation like now take x2 as a common from this, then the final equation become like see, it means the total pressure is equal to the partial pressure of the component 1 and P2 naught minus P1 into X2. Now we will discuss these equations in detail. These are the results of the Rolle's law. The following conclusions can be drawn from the above equations. The conclusion 1 is the total vapor pressure over the solution can be related to the mole fraction of either liquid 1 or the liquid 2. You can see in these equations the total vapor pressure either depends upon the mole fraction of liquid 1 or the mole fraction of the liquid 2. The second conclusion is the total vapor pressure over the solution varies linearly with the mole fraction of the component 2 or the component 1. For example, if you compare the first equation P total is equal to P naught 2 plus P naught 1 minus P 2 naught into X1. Here if you compare this equation with the line equation, this is the line equation Y is equal to C plus MX. Here C is a constant and in this equation P naught 2 is the constant. This P naught 2 is the pure vapor pressure of the liquid 2. And the difference between the constant term is also constant. It means this is a M and X is a variable. So here mole fraction can be vary. You can add the liquid 1 and the liquid 2. It means the amount of the liquid 1 and liquid 2 can be changes. It means X1 can be vary. So this equation Y is equal to C plus MX can be satisfied with this equation. Here Y is the P total, C is the P naught 2 and M is the difference between the P1 naught minus P2 naught and X is the X1. Similarly, when you compare this with the P total P1 naught plus P2 naught minus P1 X2. Here PT is Y, P1 naught is C constant. And the difference between P02 minus P1 is M and X2, which is a variable, is X. Okay, it means both are the satisfied the linear equations. The third conclusion, that is a very very important. Depending on the vapor pressure of the pure component 1 and 2, total vapor pressure over the solution decreases or increases with the increase or decrease of the mole fraction. It means if you change the amount of the liquid 1 or the liquid 2, ultimately the value of the total vapor pressure will also change. We will understand the conclusion 3 with the help of the graph. Let us suppose the partial pressure of the liquid 1 is less than the partial pressure of the liquid 2. It means the liquid 1 is less volatile than the liquid 2. Less volatile means the liquid 1 boils at the higher temperature as comparison to the liquid 2. Now, according to this equation, P total is equal to P1 naught plus P2 naught minus P1 naught into X2. This is our equation number 2. If P1 is less than the P02, it means their difference having some positive value, then P total ultimately increases. And if P1 naught is greater than the P2 naught, P total ultimately decreases. The same thing is written in the conclusion 3. The total vapor pressure over the solution decreases or increases with the increase or decrease in the mole fraction. Now let us suppose that this is a closed container having the liquid one only. If this container, closed container having the liquid one only, it means the mole fraction of x1 is equal to the 1 and x2 ultimately 0 because there is a no liquid 2 here. And ultimately the pressure, total pressure is equal to the P1 naught. Now if you add x2 means the liquid 2 in this container, the amount of liquid 2 continuously increases and the amount of the x1 in the whole solution ultimately decreases. It is evident that if the mole fraction is decreases, if the mole fraction is decreases, the total vapor pressure is also decreases. When as the amount of x2 is increases, ultimately x1 is decreases. We know that x2 plus x1 is equal to 1. Let us suppose at the particular time x2 become 1 and x1 ultimately become to 0. When x2 become 1, it means the P total become equal to the P naught 2. Here P1 present on the lower side and P2 is present on the upper side due to this. Because the P naught 2 is greater than the P1 naught. Now, according to Rolle's law, P1 is equal to the P1 naught x1 and P2 is equal to the P naught 2 x2. Compare this with the linear equation y is equal to mx. Now, if x2 is increases, ultimately x1 is decreases. If x1 is decreases, then the value of the P naught 1 is also decreases. This is the first line. This equation is satisfied. This equation P1 naught x1 naught, it means this is a graph 1. Means as a x2 is increases, x1 is decreases. Now if you increase the amount of x1, ultimately the value of the P naught 2 is decreases and this is the graph 2. When you add both equations, P total is equal to the P1 plus P2, and you will get the third equation, that is equal to the P total P1 naught plus P2 naught. Now see bache, in this equation if you put the value of x2 is equal to 0, P total ultimately equal to the value of the P1 naught, and if you put the value of the x1 is equal to 0, then P total ultimately equal to the value of the P naught 2. Now we will see the composition of the solution in the vapor phase only. Let us suppose this is a closed container. The black one is a liquid one and the red one is a liquid 2. The partial vapor pressure of the liquid one is a P1 naught and the partial pressure of liquid 2 is a P2 naught. Now in the vapor phase, the mole fraction of the liquid one is Y1 and the mole fraction of the liquid 2 is Y2. Now the vapor pressure of P1 is equal to the Y1 P total and P2 is equal to the Y2 P total. In general, we can say if the more than two liquids are present in the solution, then PI is equal to the VI PT. Now we are going to solve the numerical based on the Rolle's law. In this numerical, the pure vapor pressure of chloroform and dichloromethane is given as 200 mm of the mercury and 415 mm of the mercury. In the first part, we have to calculate the value of total vapor pressure of the solution. When you mix the 25.5 gram of
chloroform and 40 gram of the dichloromethane. And in the second part, we have to calculate the mole fraction of each component in vapor phase. In the second part, we have to calculate the value of Y1 and Y2. Now, see the solution of this numerical. See, in the first part, we have to calculate the value of P total. We can calculate the value of P total by this formula. Pt is equal to P1 naught plus P2 naught minus P1 into X2. Let us suppose the chloroform is the liquid 1 and dichloromethane is the liquid 2. For the liquid 1, P1 naught is the pure vapor pressure of the chloroform. The value is given 200 mm of the mercury. And for the liquid 2, the pure vapor pressure is 415 mm of the mercury. Both the values are given in the numerical. Now W1 and the W2 are the weight of chloroform and the dichloromethane. W1 is the weight of the chloroform, that is given 25.5 gram, and W2 is 40 gram, that is the weight of dichloromethane. Now see in the formula, we have the value of P1 naught, P2 naught and P1 naught again. But the value of X2 is missing. We can calculate the value of X2. X2 is the mole fraction. We can calculate the mole fraction value by this formula. X2 is equal to N2 over N1 plus N2. N2 is the number of moles of dichloromethane and N1 is the number of moles of chloroform. We can calculate the number of moles by this formula. Number of moles equal to the mass over the molar mass. Molar mass of the chloroform is 119.5 gram and the molar mass of dichloromethane is 85 gram per mole. N1 is mass over the molar mass. Mass is given 25.5 gram. 25.5 over 119.5. The value of number of moles of chloroform are 0.213. Similarly, the number of moles of dichloromethane is 40 gram mass and 85 gram molar mass. The value of number of moles of dichloromethane is 0.47. Now put this value in this formula. According to this, X2 is equal to 0.47 over 0.213 plus 0.47. And the value of the mole fraction of chloromethane is 0.688. Now put all these values in this formula and we will get the total vapor pressure of the solution. You can calculate the P total by this formula also. If you don't remember the previous formula, apply this formula directly. The P total is P1 naught X1 plus P2 naught X2. X2 value is given. We know that X1 is X1 plus X2 is equal to 1 and X1 is equal to 1 minus X2. X2 value we already calculated 0.688 and we will get the value of X1 0.312. You can calculate the value of X1 by this formula also. In the second part, we have to calculate the value of the mole fraction of each component in vapor phase. In the vapor phase, we know that the relation according to the Dalton's law of partial pressure is P1 is equal to Y1 Pt. Now P1 is the pressure of component 1 in solution. According to Rawls' law, we can calculate the value of P1 by this formula. P1 is equal to P1 naught X1. P naught value is given to you. X1 we calculated here. Put this value and we will get the value of P1. Now you can easily calculate the value of Y1. Y1 is equal to P1 62.4 mm of mercury, and P total is we already calculated in the first part, 347.9, and we will get the value of Y1 is 0.18. And similarly, you can calculate the value of Y2 by the formula P2 over P total. P2 is P2 naught X2. X2 value is calculated 0.688, and P2 naught is 415. The value is P2 is 285.5 mm of mercury, and put this value in this formula, and Y2 is 285.5 over 347.9, and we will get the value of Y2 is 0.82. Now, can you tell out of component 1 and component 2 which is more volatile? Yes, dichloromethane having high vapor pressure, therefore it is more volatile than chloroform. It is clearly seen in this picture. The Y2 having value 0.82 and Y1 having value 0.81. It means the vapors of dichloromethanes are greater than the vapors of chloroform. Now try to solve the numerical 2.13 and 2.16. From the back exercise, this is your homework.